This is how the function will look like. You now go up, come down again. You see now, that's another point. It will now come down to minus 5.2. Let this place be like minus 5.2 at point 1.4. So now, it will now come down again. It will come down till when it gets to minus 5.2, it will, you see, go up again. It will go up. So that means this place that is going up, this place is 1.4. Do you understand? So that's how it will be. Then it goes up forever. Goes up forever. Sketch the graph of Px equal x raised to power 4 plus x raised to power 3 minus 6x squared. Now, for you to be able to sketch graph of something, there's one paramount thing you need to know. Look at it. You need to differentiate. You need to find the derivative, and I'll show you how the derivative is going to help us. Do you understand? Differentiate the p dx is equal to 4s. Don't forget the power will come down, then subtract one from the power. 4s raised to power 3 plus 3s squared minus 2x. Don't forget, at the turning point, either at maximum or minimum point, or at local maximum or at local minimum point, the y dx is always 0. Equate this to 0 first. 4s raised to power 3 plus 3s squared minus 12s equal what? 0. Factorize this. You are left with 4s squared plus 3x minus 12 equal to 0. So when you solve this, s equal to 0, or 4s raised to power 3 plus 3s minus 12 equals 0. Solve the quadratic equation. You need to be able to solve the quadratic equation. I don't want to waste time. I want to use calculator to solve it. You can use formula method to solve this quadratic equation. It doesn't matter. You know you have to show working. Use formula method to solve it. So you have a 4, 3, minus 12. So the first answer is 1.397 something. But let me just, I will round off to 1.4. That means if I put 1.4 inside this, I will get 0. Now, the second answer is minus 2.1. That's what I want to do. Now, do you get that? Now, let us determine the maximum and the minimum point. You know, this is a turning point, or we call this stationary point. Differentiate this thing the second time. Look at what we have. The square p over the x square. This one will give me what? 12x. 12x square plus 6x, right? Minus 12. When x is 0, the square p over the x square will actually be minus 12, which is less than 0, which is a maximum point. It's a maximum point. Now, when x is greater than 0, when x is equal to 1.4, what happened? When x is equal to 1.4, you do the square p over the x square. Anyway, it's here, put 1.4. You can quickly use your calculator on this. You have 12 multiplied by 1.4 all square plus 6 multiplied by 1.4 minus 12. The answer is 19.92 is what? Greater than 0. This is a minimum point. They call it local minimum. Now again, when x is minus negative 2.1, d square p over the s square is equal to what? Put s to be negative 2.1, there you have 12 multiplied by 2.1 square or minus 2.1 square minus 6 or plus 6 multiplied by minus 2.1 minus 12. The answer we get is 28.32, which is also greater than 0, which is also a minimum point. So we have two local minimum points. Now look at what I'm now going to do. Now you will now check from minus infinity to infinity. Let's say this is where we want to draw the graph. Let's say this is our this thing. This is y. This is x. Not draw to scale, but look at it. I want to scale this graph here. You know, this is from minus infinity to what? Infinity. So for x. So what do we have? Look at what I'm going to do. I'm going to draw a table. You need to see what I'm doing here. For x, I have f prime of x or the pds, right? You know, I want to draw the graph of p, then p of x itself. Now look at what I'm going to do. These 3 points have indicated something for me. It means between minus infinity and 2.1, you know, if I start from minus infinity, between minus infinity, and then you come, you first get, you know, when you are coming from minus infinity is here, minus infinity, and you come, you are starting from here, you now come, the first place you get to is minus 2.1, right? The second place you get to is 0.0, the third place you get to is 1.4, then to infinity again. Do you understand? Now, you will now tell me what is happening here from between minus infinity and minus 2.1. See, this is a specific point you need to take note. That is why those this stationary point, you need to take note of those points. So between minus infinity and 2.1, what is the yds? If you check the yds, pick a number between minus infinity and 2.1. Let's say minus 100. Minus 100 is between minus infinity and the minus 2.1. Put minus 100 inside that value, inside the PDS. Put minus 100. Okay, this one will be minus, just put minus 100 for, press calculator, plus 3 S squared minus 12 S. When S is minus 100, it is giving you what? A negative value. That means, let me tell you something. That means that between minus any number you put between minus infinity and minus 2.1, you will get a negative value. Do you understand? So that means the PDS is always negative in this interval. If you start from minus infinity, you must cover from minus infinity to infinity. That is the point. Do you understand? So, but you have to stop at some point. See, this is from minus infinity to infinity. But you have to stop at some point. Where are the points you need to stop? Stationary points. So you will start from minus infinity till you get to the first stationary point. The first stationary point is minus 2.1. So you will now check, is the PPS always positive there or always negative? What does that mean? It means pick any value here, put it inside the PDS, and see whether the answer you get will be a plus, a negative, a positive answer, or a negative answer. But if you put minus 2.1, minus 2.1 is the solution, it will give you 0. But then, if you take any number less, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, you get to, as it increases, you get to minus infinity. If you are putting it inside this, as inside this function, you will be getting a negative value. And what does that mean? Whenever the PDS, whenever the derivative of a function is negative, it means that function is decreasing. It means that function is what? Decreasing. This is how you write it. This one just indicates that it is what? Decreasing. So it is decreasing from, you see, you get my point? It is decreasing like that. Now, when you now start from, I'm done with that one. So minus 2.1, you will not go again. No, as I was telling you, this is minus 2.1. Stop at the next stationary point. The next stationary point is what? Zero. Right? From minus 2.1 to zero, if you put, take any value between minus 2.1 and zero. Take any value between minus 2.1 and zero, what do you get? Let's take what is between minus 2.1 and 0. Minus 1 is between minus 2.1 and 0. Put it inside the PDS. Put minus 1 inside the PDS. Calculate when S is minus 1. The answer is 11. That is a positive number. So between minus 1 and 0, you have a positive answer. The PDS is positive. And when the PDS, when the derivative of a function is positive, it means that the function is increasing. You will draw it this way. It means that the function is what? Increasing. Do you see the way I'm doing it? Now, from zero now to the next one. From zero to the next stationary point. To the next stationary point is 1.4. Between zero and 1.4, I have 1.4 here. Now, check. Any number between 0 and 1.4, 1 is between 0 and 1.4, or 0.9 is between them. Calculate, put 1, for example, inside this function and see the answer, whether it will give you a positive answer or it will give you a negative answer. Put 1 there, put 1. The answer is minus 5. If you put 1 there, the answer is minus 5. That means it's negative again. Between 0 and 1.4, This the PDS is negative, and when the derivative of a function is negative, it means the function is what? Decreasing. Do you understand? It means the function is decreasing. Now, then lastly, there is no more stationary point. I have a 1.4. So after 1.4, I go down to what? Infinity. So I will now start again from 1.4 down to infinity. If I start from 1.4 down to infinity, pick any number between 1.4 and infinity. Pick 100, pick 200, pick any value. Actually, I'll put it inside the PDS. You see that the answer you are going to get will be a positive answer. The answer you are going to get will be a positive answer. So, because of that, this one will be positive. It means that this function will increase. Do you get that? So, what does that mean? So, when S is negative infinity, it is coming down from negative infinity. That means, you see how I'll draw this function now? So, till you get to minus 2.1. So, what is P of X at minus 2.1? You have to get the answer. P of X at minus 2.1. What is P of X? P of X is S raised to power 4. Right, plus s raised to power 3 minus 6x squared. Now, at point minus 2.1, if you put minus 2.1, you know that's the answer we got when we find the solution to this. You are supposed to get 0, but put it on p of x, put minus 2.1 there. The answer is minus 16.3 approximately, or I'm working with approximate value. Do you understand? So you come again, so that means minus 2.1 is minus 3. So that means the function will come down. This is what it means. So between from minus infinity to minus 2.1, the function will come down. So when it gets to minus 16.3 on the y-axis on p of x, this y-axis is the same thing as p of x. This is the x-axis. Do you understand? Because they call it this one P of X, so it's the Y axis. Do you understand my point? Now, I'm explaining something. So, at this rate, it will now come up and get to zero. When it gets to zero, what is P of X? Put zero here. Is zero plus zero minus zero? The answer is zero. So, that means it will get to zero. That means it will come up again and get to zero. When it gets to zero, it will come down again. Till when you get to 1.4, put 1.4 in anywhere you see inside this one. Put 1.4 there. Anyway, see, let's put 1.4. So 1.4 raised to power 4 plus 1.4 raised to power 3 minus 6 times 1.4. Calculate 1.4. So the answer is minus 5.2 approximately. So that's when you get to minus 5.2, then it goes up to infinity and it has no end again. Do you understand? So now let me now sketch the graph for you. You can see it's from it's coming from up down. So look at what I'm going to do. This is minus 2.1 that I've ticked. I told you not to draw to scale. Let this place be minus 16.3. You know, this is a negative value. This is zero. Then I have 1.4. Let me draw it well. Let this place be minus 2.1. Let this place be 1.4. Right? Let this place be 1.4. Not drawn to scale. You can use graph to draw it. But then look at, so that means the function will be coming all the way up. It will be coming down. Do you see? Decreasing from minus infinity. This is from minus. It will be coming down till it gets to minus 16.3. It will be coming down, and the value of x at that point is minus 2.1. So it will be coming down till it gets to this place, minus 16.3 on this spot. Do you see what I'm trying to do? So it will come down till you get here, it will now go up. So the function will come down when it gets here. That will be the like the grand minus 16.3 as I showed you. It will now go up. When x is 0, y is 0, it will now, you see, go up, come down again. This is how the function will look like. It will now go up, come down again. You see now, that's another point. It will now come down to minus 5.2. Let this place be like minus 5.2 at point 1.4. So now, it will now come down again. It will come down till, when it gets to minus 5.2, it will, you see, go up again. It will go up. So that means this place that is going up, this place is 1.4. Do you understand? So that's how it will be. Then it goes up forever. Goes up forever. So this function, this is the diagram. This is the this is how to sketch that function. Thank you very much. Please kindly subscribe to this YouTube channel. Thank you.